Good afternoon, everyone. Today is Tuesday, the 26th of April 2022, and I thought I'd vlog this afternoon and this evening because today I am off to the Sunderland Empire with my friend Waffle. We're going to see a brand new musical called The Cher Show. I've heard a little bit about it, mainly with like the three Chers, and I'm very impressed with the casting for this show. I think I only know about two or three songs in the Cher back catalogue, and I know nothing about Cher as a singer, person, whatever, so I'm really excited to go and see this show. Now, I'm not being endorsed by Sunderland or by the Cher Show or anything, but because I'm an honest person like that, I thought I'd give full disclosure. I haven't paid full price for my ticket tonight. I have a friend, Hannah, who is the deputy stage manager for the show, and she has sent me a link for £10 tickets for tonight and some £20 seats for tomorrow. But I'm only seeing it tonight. As far as I'm aware, Sunderland Empire are charging, I think, the cheapest price seats are £19.50 and the top price seats are like £59.50. I'll check on that for you and I'll put it down here somewhere about prices. But yeah, I feel really lucky because I was able to then, with the code Hannah sent me, get £10 seats in the stalls. And they look really good seats. And yeah, right now I'm heading into Newcastle to go and meet Waffle. She's just finishing work. And then we're going for some food and then we'll get the metro to Sunderland to go and watch the show. So come along with us. Share to my sunny. It's Waffle! Here we are at Fat Hippo. I've got a chocolate milkshake. Waffle is here and she's got a slush thing, alcoholic slush, which looks like it's dripping lovely into her dish. Excited for tonight, Waffle?
Very excited.
And are you quite familiar with Cher? Because I'm not really.
If I could turn back time.
But do you know any other songs?
No.
So yeah, both of us don't really know much about Cher as a person, much about her music, bar a couple of songs. It's going to be interesting.
I think we'll remember more songs when she sings them. I reckon we'll know more than we think we do.
Yeah, because I was like that about the Carole King musical, Beautiful, where I actually knew more songs, but I didn't know she wrote them, you see. It'll be good.
Have fun.
So we've come to a pub for a quick drink before the show. I've got a Frobisher's apple and raspberry juice. Waffle's got a pint.
Because I am a lady.
Because she's a lady. And there's the theatre just there. And this pub is called the Dunk Cow, if you're interested. How's your pint, Waff?
Beautiful, nice pint. It's very handy for next door to the cinema. To the theatre.
Yeah, of
and
course,
darling. And it's rather reasonably priced.
Yes. As she declared to the barman, God, this is cheaper than Newcastle.
Cheaper than Newcastle. Cheers.
Shall we take Waffle's phone and take a lot of pictures? I think so. Hi, Waffle.
Hi. Are we having the wand?
Yes.
Originally. It's on hold.
Look at her, beautiful. Thank you for trusting me with your bag and your phone.
Oh, what have you done to my phone? Have you taken pictures on my phone of yourself? Everybody does that. Oh, I need to stop doing that. Oh, you do.
Lovely.
I am. I've told you once.
That last clip was me showing you some of the merch that they've got. They've got a few t-shirts, a few hoodies. I've got a program which cost me £5. Over there is a lovely little backdrop of the Cher, like, facade. And next to that there is where press and celebrities are all hiding in the background and stuff. Because it is press night tonight, so there's a lot of press there. I'm happy to be here with Waffle. She's just gone to the toilet and told me not to take any more pictures on her phone. And then shortly we're going to head down and go and take our seats for the show. So, very exciting. Waffle with her pint and cocktail. And it is a pint, isn't it?
No, it's not a pint of cocktail, it's a long drink.
It's a pint.
Very long drink.
I'm wounded. I'm absolutely wounded. I'm
What do you think it looks like,
Waffle? Right, I think it reminds me of Return to Oz, where she has all her heads in the cabinets, and she twists and changes her heads. That's what the set reminds me of.
She's not allowed any more alcohol this evening.
Look.
She's had enough. It looks quite interesting, the set design, I'm not going to lie. I'm interested to see what happens now.
Yeah, so you need to cut to the pictures of the heads, so they understand what I'm talking about.
They've seen the heads.
Oh, okay.
Shh, Waffle. Quiet time now.
Well, I want to hear yours first.
I've got different shares for different reasons. Which one do you like best?
So it's the interval, and what do you think of it, Waffle? Tell
it's
me your thoughts.
It's amazing. Thoughts. The storytelling is brilliant, and it's told in a way that I didn't expect it was going to be told in.
No.
And it's better.
Yeah, it is very clever. I really like Millie O'Connell as young Cher. Like, she's really good at playing the young Orc.
She's got
Cher.
Mannerisms. Perfect.
But then Danielle Steers as the slightly older Cher, like in the mid-20s Cher.
Her voice is outstanding.
Her voice is really powerful.
Yeah. But I suppose Cher's voice was growing. So maybe that's why we didn't hear the power in the first Cher's voice.
Yeah. And Debbie we haven't really heard from yet, but in the little bits that she's done.
Yeah.
And the set design is really clever as well. There's not a lot of set, some of it comes up and from the sides. They've got two staircases that they use quite a lot of.
It's really clever how they've introduced the dates.
Yes.
So, like, the date will be on the back of the bed, or the date coming on.
It's kind
on,
of subtle, like,
covers.
Yeah,
really
or on the mirror, like, with 1975.
Yeah, I like
that. Really good. And the lighting as well, the lighting's amazing, the costumes. All the costumes are really fantastic so far. Very kind of like authentic
and
to the
introduction
era.
Of other songs that aren't just their songs is a really good intro into it. I love
such
the Bang Bang.
Oh, the Bang Bang, yeah.
Nancy Sinatra, I love
that's
that.
Such a Bang Bang, like that's in it. And I didn't know she did backing vocals on To Do Rom
no,
Rom.
No, I didn't know that either.
Yeah.
What'd she
say? Shoop Shoop. Shoop Shoop, yeah. I have the program, but there's no song list. I don't know if it's in the souvenir brochure. I'm not paying another £10 for that. So
no, it's good. Yeah. That's the first half.
We've got cocktail each, and we're gonna head back to our seats, ready for the second half. So see you afterwards.
Bye
now. Bye
now.
Maybe I'm too good for you, oh, to be.
So it's the day after the night before, and this is my Cher program, which I think I showed you last night. The second half was really good. It started off in 1975 with Debbie Currip as the older Cher, taking over from Danielle Steers. And it flew by really quickly for an hour. Again, it was all the hits, all the music of Cher. And my thoughts are this. It's a good show, but it's not fantastically well laden with story. There is story there, but it does seem to be mostly about hitting out all the big songs of Cher rather than focusing on the story. Like, you got brief glimpses of everything, like her time with her mum, and I actually found out more reading about Cher online. So I didn't know Cher had spent time as a child in an orphanage, and then it glossed over her relationship with Sonny a little bit. Like, he shouted her at one point, so you got the feeling there was maybe domestic violence involved. But again, it kind of glossed over and swept over that really quickly, and the rest of her relationships. It didn't go into great depth. And I think that's a shame, because I do like a story with good depth. Like, it seems to me that the producers of Cher, the Cher show, seem like they really want to focus on making sure the dates are right for when certain things happened. And if you compare it to, say, the likes of Jersey Boys, where Jersey Boys isn't factually accurate as such with when certain songs and certain things happened within the band's personal lives, but, you know, they get those points out there, and they get those crucial events out there with this generalised kind of date timeline, which I think works better than how the Cher show has done it. But the costumes were amazing. As you'll have seen, I'm going to try and have put in the remix kind of thing that we were allowed to film. So I hope you've enjoyed that, if it's not been copyrighted. And yeah, really good show. I wouldn't rush to go and see it again. Like I said, for me, I would have liked a bit more depth to the stories, but all the music was really good, and if you're a Cher fan, you will love it. So if you see this video before it finishes its run in Sunderland, go check it out in Sunderland, because you are pretty much guaranteed a full cast, as the understudies are not yet rehearsed for their cover roles yet. That's happening this week, according to my friend Hannah. Pure enjoyment. It was a fun night out. Waffle enjoyed it, though she felt some of the Millie's mannerisms of Cher were a bit too distracting as well from the part and from the show. But she said, Waffle even said, like, maybe that's just how she's been directed, and she's obviously watched YouTube videos of Cher back in the 60s and stuff, so she's trying to copy that, which I get. But yeah, that was Waffle's only criticism of the piece. I did enjoy it. I was singing along to Believe and a few of the other songs, and costumes. Oh, the costumes were amazing. And the ensemble are perfect as well. Like, the choreography isn't the best choreography I've ever seen in a Western musical or musical show, but it's really tight. It's really good. And you can tell they're working very hard at it. And I'm interested to see how the show develops, if there's any changes, whether it'll make it to London. Yeah, so go and check it out, guys. If you liked this little vlog, comment down below, hit subscribe, all the good stuff. And I will see you with another vlog very, very soon. Bye for now.